again. Happy Sunday. I just realized it was, I spent the whole day thinking it was Monday. The whole day. And then it's Sunday. Yeah, so there you go. So this morning, I spent the night at the cabin, and Jan from Butterfly Tracks and I, she wanted to do a van tour of my new van, because she has a very wonderful van tour on her channel of my minivan. And so we wanted to do a van. So where we were, where she was staying and where we stayed last night was a little congested and not too much space to do a tour. So we came to the grocery store parking lot. So we spent the morning in the grocery store parking lot. We did have a lot of traffic noise. There were helicopters, there were sirens, and we had to keep taking breaks. But we just pulled in at the edge of the grocery store parking lot, and we just went for it. So we did the tour, and so that broke up about noon or one, and then I had my lunch, and then I haven't left the parking lot. I've been here all day. I put my solar panels out. My power was a little low. I said I need to stay put today, so I did that, and I cooked some rice in my I used my butane stove because I didn't want to use any power. I wanted to make power and not use it and save it. So just, it's kind of like you know, it's kind of like money in the bank. You know, it's kind of like you put some in, you withdraw, and you decide what you want to spend it on. And it's just like spending money. I'm just spending energy, and so I just was like, no, I'm gonna do the rice with the butane today and just conserve, because I'm not too sure about the next few days, because I have no idea where I'm going or what I'm doing on what days. I have this things I don't need to know. Like, I don't need to know. So I'm leaving this area now. I'm heading towards an area that I'm meeting with a friend in a couple of days. So I'll just head in that direction. But I also need to stay in the area of that Apple store. And just to clarify, when I've been talking about the Apple store in my videos, it's not, I'm not buying apples. I'm not going apple picking. It's the Apple store for like service on my iPad. Somebody wanted to know where I was going apple picking. I thought that was so cute. And I realized I really wasn't clear. I was calling it the Apple store. And so I need to go there as soon as I get that email that says my new keyboard is in. I need to be at that particular Apple store and pick it up. So I will just hover. I will hover. But as of right now, I'm about an hour and a half away. So I'm going to head in that direction, and I'll look for the first, as soon as it starts getting dark and I decide that I don't want to drive anymore when it gets dark, I'll just look for the next either rest stop, truck stop, welcome centers. No, there won't be any welcome centers. Those are at state lines. I will look for Cracker Barrels. I'll look for anything. It just doesn't matter. It's just wherever it takes me. So, yeah. So we'll see. We'll see where the journey takes me today. And what traffic I'll sit in tonight. No, I don't want to be negative. Again, so I'm on the I'm on Route 4 in traffic, and I'm leaving Celebration, Florida. Isn't that a nice name for a town? Celebration, Florida. It's near Orlando. I'm going by signs that say Epcot this way, Magic Kingdom that way, Universal Studios that way, and to be honest, I'd rather stick pins in my eyes than go to either of those places. Just not my thing. Not my thing. I'd rather spend the day in Publix parking lot. Just being by myself and hoping online. I was reading comments and responding to some comments in my on my channel. I would do that any day. If somebody gave me a free ticket to go to Disney World, I'd rather do that in Publix parking lot. I'm just being totally honest. If you love if you love Disney, a lot of people love Disney. That's great. There's things, that's why there's things that everybody likes, and then there's things that other people like, and then that's why there's different things. There's things that, there's things for all of us to enjoy. There's things for all of us to enjoy. That's why there's all kinds of things to do. You know, this channel that I started, this will not be a travel vlog. I mean, I do van life, and I am traveling, but you will hardly see me doing anything that's remotely touristy. The only reason I would is if there was a group of gals and everybody was going to a certain kind of touristy area or an event or something, and I just wanted to socialize. If I wanted to socialize, I would do that. And I don't hate it. You know, it's not like, oh, I just don't choose it. I don't choose it. It's just not my way of spending my time in the way in which I prefer. And that's what makes us, it's a gosh darn good thing that we're all different. Because if we were all the same, this earth would be boring. But it makes us all interesting, just how we just all tick a little different, you know? And I love the way I tick. I just love the way I tick. And I hope you love the way you tick. And if you don't, just love it. Because, you know, like, you know, whatever you're choosing to do, as long as it brings you joy and it does, it's not hurting anybody else, then go do it and have fun. And so I did enjoy a nice big salad for lunch today. Oh, so good. Right after my van tour, I had a beautiful lunch. And right before I pulled out of Publix parking lot, I made another big salad with hummus and opened up a can of artichoke hearts. I got the whole can in there. The whole can of artichoke hearts with like shredded carrots and onions and cabbage and oil and some hummus and the rice I made earlier. So I'm going to, as soon as the sun is setting right now, it's really low. That's why it's coming under my visor. Sign says rest area 10 miles. So in 10 miles, I'm going to pull into that rest area, wherever I am. I'm well away from Celebration, and I'm heading toward the area that I'm going to be, I want to hover around for the next couple of days. And I'm just, as long as I'm heading in the right direction, it's fine. It doesn't matter how far I go. So in 10 miles, I'll check out this rest area, and I'll just see if it, I'll look and see if they, it says no overnight parking. Once in a while, you'll see one of those in Florida, but really nowhere else. Every other state that I've traveled in, if it says rest area, you go and rest, even if it's overnight. But sometimes in Florida, it will say no overnight parking. So I won't stay. And then I'll just look for a truck stop. I'll look for a Love's or a Flying J's or a Pilot or in a Cracker Barrel. I'll figure it out. I'm not worried at all. We'll see where I hunker down tonight. Wherever I decide to call home tonight is going to feel like home, and it's going to be comfy, cozy. I'll be as snug as a bug in a gosh darn rug back there. When Jan from Butterfly Tracks and I were together last night, we had a belly laugh. I haven't had a laugh like that in a long time. Well, I laugh every day. I'm laughing all the time. But I'm talking when it hurts and you're crying. Like we needed to get the tissues, both of us. We were just silly, and there was just a couple of things that were tickling our funny bone. And I just really appreciate, there is just nothing that feels better than that belly laugh that just, you can't even breathe and you're crying. Oh, we were killing ourselves laughing. It was so fun. And I just loved spending that time with her. I'm so grateful that I was invited, and I'm so grateful to have met her at a meetup. I just met her at a meetup, and she asked me for a tour, and that was it, you know? And I'm so grateful to have met her and to be blessed with her presence. And for that belly laugh last night, oh man, we would die laughing. It was so fun. One thing that you should know about me is that I swear like a sailor. I have a mouth like a truck driver. No offense to truck drivers, that's just an expression. I don't know if it's a Massachusetts expression, but I got a mouth like a truck driver. And I am surprisingly not very challenged when I turn this camera on. I don't have to edit it out. I'm finding it very easy to just not use those very colorful words that I'm so well known for using. Yeah, it's kind of nice. Yeah. I thought that I would just be, oh my goodness, how am I going to have a conversation? How do I have a conversation without those beautiful words that feel so fun to say? I'm doing it, and it's not even, I don't even feel really challenged. I just, it's not like when I'm doing editing, I have to edit it all out. It's not like I have to talk myself out of it. I don't know, it's coming naturally. I wonder if, I'm not gonna stop. Here I am again, still in traffic. I decided not to stop at that rest stop. Even it was 10 miles away, and I thought, you know, I haven't driven all day. I'm gonna do some mileage. So I've probably gone another 30 or 40. And I see a Cracker Barrel coming up. Cracker Barrel parking lots are my new best friend. You know, they feel good because, like, you just belong there. Like, they let you stay there. They want you there. It works out most of the time for them because people that stay in their parking lot go in there and eat. I don't go in there and eat, and I don't feel bad that I don't. There's nothing in that store that I want. There's nothing I want. So I'm not going to go in there and reciprocate. The way that I look at it is that, yes, they're serving me. They're serving me by allowing me to park there. And then, in turn, I serve others. Maybe not Cracker Barrel, but you can put your service out into the world in the ways that make sense for you, and that it just feels authentic and beautiful and not obligatory. So that's how I look at it. Somebody might think like, oh, Lola, you should go in there and spend some money. You know, you just park there and you're, you know, you're just mooching off them. It's not the way I see it. The way I see it is that they allow people to park there. I'm allowing them to give to me, and I'm receiving. And then I go and give elsewhere. And there's people that need things from me in other ways. And they get enough, I think they get enough people that do spend money there and do eat there, that makes it worth it for them to just let people park in their parking lots overnight. And most of the time, people are in there spending money. And that's, I think that's why they're doing it. But I wonder if there's some founder of that chain or somebody involved in the business management of that chain that is just has a giving heart. I wonder if it is all about going in there and eating. What if there's something charitable about the person that manages that chain? You know, what if? What if? I like to think, whenever you don't know, I always say, like, if you don't know something for sure, always go with the idea that feels the most pleasant and the most beautiful and the most kind. Go with that one. Why go with the yucky one, you know? That's just my way. So here I am at the Cracker Barrel again. I'm a regular in the Cracker Barrel.
It's dark out. It's a beautiful night. It feels very comfortable. I have my big salad. I'm eating later than usual because I had a late lunch because the van tour went kind of past my lunchtime. So I had lunch a little bit later than usual. So I'm having dinner a little bit later than usual. And I feel really good. I'm telling you, the stars have aligned because I just Googled and I'm 7 minutes away from a Planet Fitness. So I'll go grab a shower in the morning and I'm 15 minutes from a Whole Foods Market, and I enjoy Whole Foods Market, and there's not a lot of them in Florida, but there's one 15 minutes away. So tomorrow, get her done. Shower, Whole Foods Market, and then I perhaps will be going to stay with my van life friend who I met at a meetup, and I'm looking forward to seeing her. I love her dearly. It's just a wonderful life. It's all good. Everything is good. Yum-o. Yum-o.